Good morning, Jew.
Morning, Jew, to you.
This is Heather Gold in Oakland with my good friend, Katie.
Hi, I'm Katie Halper.
Katie
in
Halper.
In New York City. I thought she was going to introduce me. I'm sorry.
In the center of, I can. You can speak for yourself.
No, it's good. I like that. No, don't mind. No, forget about me. Don't mind me. Don't mind me.
And this is Morning Jew, where we look at the headlines and ask the most important question, is it good for the Jews? How you get your America? Like, I like to dedicate every show to somebody that you don't think is Jewish, and you get to hear their real name. So Michael Bolotin, a.k.a. Michael Bolton, the man who once opened for Ozzy Osbourne in his heavy metal band, this is for you. Hard to believe he's Jewish, but he is. He's Jewish.
Mazel tov. L'chaim. From my, I can't believe they're not Jewish. I'm going to go with a Michael also. And also Michael Richards.
It's sort of Michael Shame Day.
It is. Well, I'm proud of Michael Bolton because he also did that funny video with Lonely Island. It was very funny.
Yeah.
But Michael Richards, I think, was an affirmative action hire on Seinfeld. He is not actually Jewish.
Our first story this week is state of Kansas. The House of Representatives there passed a law saying that anybody in any public accommodation, isn't that phrase public accommodation just take you right back to 1966, even though we weren't alive? Anybody with a public accommodation, a hotel or a restaurant or a public park, can discriminate against gay people to protect their religious beliefs. Like, I so religiously believe that gay is so bad, I get to not serve you flowers, give you a wedding cake, let you sit in the park.
Because they're like, what would Jesus do? And Jesus would say, I would not bake them a cake. I would not turn wine into water for that person. Water into wine. Which direction is it?
What Jesus would say is there's a velvet rope and you can go back. Yeah. What is going on? Kansas, it didn't pass. It got stopped in the Senate, apparently, of Kansas. But the reason we're going to talk about this is because this is part of the backlash to gay marriage, and it's happening all over the country, so we're going to get a lot more of these laws.
Heather, just so you know, I like to mention whenever it's relevant, is a jurist. She went to law school.
Listen.
So she has a nice perspective on
it. She has Jewish pride, like a lot of Jews like to believe.
I'm quelling.
I'm glad that it brings you pleasure, because it only brought me tsuris.
Tsuris.
What does that mean, like, that to protect yourself religiously, you have to be able to turn some people away? Like, are Jews, are we going to turn people away to protect our Jewishness? And where are Jews in this? Why aren't we saying anything?
We may get turned away.
Because they keep wanting to say it's religious protection, but it's only certain kinds of Christians. So don't we need to speak up? Don't Jews need to be like, hey.
What if someone denies me a cake with the menorah on it if I want to get a Hanukkah cake? Is that kosher now for them to do it?
Or does this mean to be principally liberal, we have to be able to, like, be forced to give blintzes to anyone who wants them?
Forced.
You're shoving this down our throats.
Forced blintz distribution. That sounds like some weird, like, pre-Holocaust slippery slope thing. Not sure. Like, it was Kristallnacht, and then the Jews had to give away blintzes to everyone.
Right.
And then, you know, the rest. The rest, as they say, is history.
It's sort of an inverse. It's like it would be the opposite of the Holocaust. You're not going to stop all your Jewish activity. We're going to enforce Jewish activity.
Right.
We're going to make you do Jewishness with everybody.
Right. There's a store having a sale. Go shop now. Go haggle. Anyway.
Yeah, that's true. We can have a haggle off. How come that isn't a television show?
Oh, my God. It should be.
But you know Hagelof. They would want to name it something anti-Semitic, which I'm not going to say.
It sounds like a last name, Hagelof.
Okay, so our next story, a crypto Jew is, I think the word is converso, is that right?
Yeah.
So there was this Inquisition, you might know about it from Mel Brooks' movie.
Exactly.
The Inquisition, what a show. The Inquisition, here we go, we know you're wishing that we'd go away. But the Inquisition's here and it's here to stay.
Oh, a lot of people decide to start becoming Catholic. It seems when Jews switch, if Jews switch, it's always Catholicism. They're never like, let me become a...
Well, in all fairness, the Inquisition wasn't like, pick an alternative religion. Right. Wiccan is also available. This was the Inquisition. It was targeting Muslims and Jews. So it was very... This is also when Spain went to shit because they kicked out all their talented people, basically.
These Jews became Catholic, but still decided they'd sneak in Judaism. My sneaking in Judaism is like, I'm still going to have a blintz. Their sneaking in Judaism is we're going to light the candles. On Friday night, we're going to salt our meat and kosher it.
So these are Jews who identify, you know, they're Latino Catholics. And that's how they identify. And they think that they're Catholics and that they come from a long line of Catholics. And then they'll go to their friend's house or go to some Jewish event. And they're like, oh, that's weird. We do that too. Right. Or my grandmother wants to be buried facing east. I mean, I didn't even know that was a Jewish thing. Let's be honest. I just read in the article.
Towards
Jerusalem. Who knew? Someone either forgets to tell the next generation, or someone intentionally doesn't tell the next generation, but they keep the practices up.
Which is pretty Jewish. Like, we're going to do something. We don't know why we do it, and we're not really going to do it completely correctly.
And it's wily and sneaky.
But it's like, important that you do this.
Right.
Well, so, I mean, sneaky so you don't get killed.
Right. I mean, yeah. When I met my boyfriend, who is a Colombian, his name is Kike, which is spelled K-I-K-E, which you may recognize from the Jewish slur kike. And when I met him and asked him how he spelled his name, he told me how he spelled it. And I was like, wow, that's a Jewish slur. And he was like, oh, really? Well, I didn't know that. And I've actually never met a Jew in my life. I was like, yeah, you have. You have now. Plus, you probably have before and without knowing it. Right. And I was like, but you also look Jewish. Like, you could be Jewish. You kind of have a Jewish face. And I was like, maybe you're a crypto Jew. And it kind of turned into this joke. But then the next, on our first real date, he came to a reading that I did. And he was like, is everyone here Jewish? And I was like, no, it's not. I don't just hang out with Jews. And then I was like, but actually, since you asked about the Jewish stuff, those things over there, bagels, those are very Jewish. And he was like, oh my God, like, I eat a bagel every day. Maybe I am a crypto Jew. And he really actually thought it. And then there are all these other things that he thinks. And
maybe
he told his brother.
In New York.
Well, he does. I mean, that was the thing. But he also told his brother, he's like, maybe we're Jewish. And the brother's like, listen, don't tell that to anyone else, okay?
So let me get this straight. You came home and you're like, Mom, I met this guy. And she said, is he Jewish? And you're like, no, but he is named Kike.
Yeah.
So there's that. He's got that.
There's that, yeah.
Family.
Or that movie, Europa, Europa. Did you see that movie?
No, I didn't.
It's about a guy in Europe, somewhere in Europe. I can't remember where. He pretends to be a Nazi. And there's a terribly excruciating scene where he pretends he's trying to train his penis into being uncircumcised, and he like ties a rope around it, pulls it down, and he goes to the bathroom one day and it's like purple, blue because of the blood stuff or whatever. And that's when my friend and I decided, Steph,
you're the heterosexual, you don't know what's in a penis.
He's not bleeding, but I just mean it's like, I don't know what happens. It gets taut and it's purple and blue, and we started calling the movie Europa Europa Purple Penis Opa. So inappropriate. That was the movie we watched at camp.
It turns out there's all these people in New Mexico who are very spiritually connected to being Jewish.
And Spain is now offering passports to people who are Sephardic.
It's like a law of return. Really?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Oh, my God. This could solve everything in the Middle East. Hello.
Wow. We're getting Spain back?
Yeah. Who wants to go to Israel when you have Spain?
That's pretty good. Next for our final story. Very exciting. Turns out we've been watching the Olympics, of course. Who isn't? Watching wonderful figure skating and fabulous Johnny Weir. And so he's doing the commentary during figure skating on American television. Johnny Weir's married. Did you know that? And no, because your aunt.
No, my aunt, Linda Fredericks. Linda Fredericks, now Linda Halper.
Listen, this is how we get our news as relatives.
Yeah.
Johnny Weir's married. And Johnny Weir's husband is Jewish. Victor Voronov.
Russian Jewish.
Law school. Is a lawyer.
Georgetown Law. Not to brag, but
yeah,
a good one.
Like, kids have like wears like a V-neck sweater with like a little tie. Yeah, so they were talking about it in the news.
Once the news broke that we'd gotten married, everyone expected this huge, dramatic sort of from Sex and the City movie. But I didn't want that. My husband was actually in the closet until about a month before we were married.
Because he's Russian?
Courtship. Because he's Russian, he's Jewish, and he comes from that world. That's his truth. He comes from a very strict and judgmental sort of world. I wanted my wedding to be super low-key and just between us, and we weren't even going to invite my parents. When Victor's parents found out that we hadn't invited anybody, they cried and sobbed and said they wanted to come. And then, of course, when we said yes to them, my parents had to come as well.
Victor's family, Victor's Jewish family, freaked out.
They sobbed.
Sobbed was the word.
It was like, because they're Russian Jewish, so they were sobbing and crying.
Yeah. I think Johnny Weir marrying Yin is the best thing to happen to the Jews.
Yeah. Bringing a lot of creativity.
Even better.
Why? And why do you think so?
Why? Because he owns himself. He's everything that's fantastic about somebody who's like incredibly queer and incredibly unapologetic and expressive. I mean, first of all, it couldn't be everything less supposedly Jewish. Olympian, that right. kind of disciplined athlete, incredible physical, you know, strength. Incredibly...
We have disciplined accountants, though.
Incredibly unambivalent. Like, there's nothing ambivalent about Johnny Weir. There's nothing... He's not concerned. He's committed. He's not feeling guilty and anxious. He's not wondering and worrying.
Right.
He says he has a little OCD, so he's maybe in that sense a little bit connected. But other than that, he's just out. Bam. Which Jews right. need to be. We're working on it. Right. So, yeah. Plus, he's wonderful. I mean, maybe he'll convert. We'll get lucky.
Yeah. That would be great. Bring him on to the team. We need some more Olympians.
So Johnny Weir, good for the Jews. Mary good for Victor the Jews. Voronov. What about the crypto Jews being discovered in New Mexico? Good or bad?
I'm going to say it's good.
What makes it seem like the exciting secret thing about being Jewish is yeah, the spiritual part, which is interesting.
So makes us exotic, too. We could use less little, white.
Well, not being white isn't necessarily exotic. It's just...
For Jews, else. It is.
Well, or I guess for other people, being Jewish is exotic. So you get a that's meshing true. Of exoticness.
Right.
Double exoticness.
It's interesting. It's kind of like undoing the news where we found out that we were actually a lot whiter than we thought. Remember?
Right.
We found out we all came from one very promiscuous shiksa in Eastern Europe.
And then Kansas's law. I'd say it's mostly bad for the Jews that anybody wants to discriminate in the name of religion. That's really bad for the Jews, as I haven't heard any national outcry from Jewish organizations. Stuff. I mean, you could say it's very Jewish to have gay inclusion. Have a big party. Showbiz. It's Jewish. Let's go.
Purim? What's gayer than Purim?
Not much. What's gayer than Broadway? Not much. It's like, it's again, where the Jews and the
right.
Merging. We're going to close out with a new little thing here. We're going to do some mishpacha news. We had such a wonderful response to the Bubby phone call last week about don't go to Russia.
Don't go.
I would love to hear a message from Victor Voronov's.
I don't want anything to happen to you.
Bubby.
Don't go.
Can you imagine he's going with Johnny Weir?
Oh my God, you're right. That was who needed that message. That's who needed that message. That is weird. What a weird, I didn't even think of that. This is a weird, because that grandson was not going, he was going to East Asia.
I know.
But I feel like this grandmother had a sense she was really trying to reach out to Victor.
Well, I want to know what Victor's grandmother was saying. We need to try and get a hold. If anyone knows Victor Voronov, Johnny right. Weir's great, but we really want his Jewish husband on the show. Yeah, it's important. We have things to talk about. We want to hear about the sobbing. Thing for your everybody's messages.
Yes. And please messages. Bring them in. Send them in. We want voice messages, texts, and emails. So this one, I got an email forward to me from my friend. She says, the backstory is simply that I no longer have dental insurance and therefore hadn't gotten my teeth cleaned in quite a while.
Right.
And being the loving, involved parents that they are, both my mother and father took it upon themselves to remind me at every opportunity that I will suffer later if I don't care for my teeth now. They sent her an email that said, Dad and I are officially giving up reminding you about the dentist. You are on your own. Love you, Mom.
So this is how it goes. I'm bothering you. I don't have any money. Too bad. It's important. The future, it's terrible. Your health. You need to do it. I'm bothering you. Guess what? Go ahead. Lose your teeth. See if I care.
Yeah, lose your teeth. See if I care. Love you, Mom.
Mwah.
Mwah, call me. Or don't call me if you don't have time.
Jewish love is nagging. It's nudge. It's a nudge.
Nudge love. Not tough love. Nudge love.
Nudge love. Also, it's important to tell you all that I have a show. Anyone in the Bay Area. And it's called I Look Like an Egg, but Identify as a Cookie. It's at Shotgun Theater. Well, Monday or Tuesday, you can see me in person. There's lots of Jewish material. In fact, these shows are in memory of my Aunt Sandy because I talk about the baking ladies of the little community, my little shtetl in Niagara Falls that I grew up in. So I actually bake in the show. Plus, you all get cookies because I was raised by a Jewish woman who taught me that, of course, first rule of the religion, there must be more than enough food for everyone to eat.
What's 9 words that every Jew says?
I'm hungry.
They tried to kill us. They failed. Let's eat.
I think 9 words would be, that cake, not very moist.
But give me another piece. And
you say that while it's going in your mouth.
Exactly. I've had better. I mean, it's fine. Can I take some home with me? Look, put it in a napkin. I'm going to put some in a napkin. So
put
it
in my
bistle.
Purse. Then it's everywhere.
Yeah, put it in my purse. My grandma did it with everything. And I actually am going to be in a show too. A Laugh Liberally show this Friday.
Which
and
you we'll
put something
it.
Up for that. I did. I'm founder of Laughing Liberally, a political comedy show. Heather has performed in it.
Which is great.
And it's a great show. It's going to be fun. Juliana Forlano's in it. John Fugelsang's in it. Got great comments.
Fugelsang, he's great.
Yes, he
okay,
is.
Okay, listen, you guys, we're moving on up. We had a great show. We had a great response to last week. Please keep it going and tune in next week. Let us know how you best want to hear from us and send us your mishpucha, your family messages.
Yes, please.
All right, see you later.
Bye. See you later.